Well, well, well. Joyner Lucas has returned with a brand new album, and I think it's time we talk about it. What's going on, people? Welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to another video. Hope you guys are good, well, and safe, and all of that good stuff. Now, if you're excited for the review or you want to show me some love, press the like button. It helps push the video out to the wide world. But I'm not gonna lie, I think it's time we just break this down. No long intro, let's just get into it. So before we actually properly break this album down, I want to take us to earlier on this year when Joyner dropped ADHD. The album that people have been waiting for such a long time had come out, and really and truly was very disappointing. A lot of the songs we'd heard, a lot of the vibe was disjointed. It didn't really feel that great with new features with like Young Thug in there. It was just very flat and very bland, and I kind of saw myself looking at Joyner Lucas like, are you done? Are you finished? When I saw Joyner Lucas was kind of slowly building up to drop this second project of the year, Evolution, I was just looking at it like San Andreas. Ah, here we go again. Obviously, you know the other word that should have been in there. Harboring those feelings of, if he messes this up, it could be done for Joyner. You know, and I don't like kind of canceling people, because it's not cancel culture, but saying that an artist is kind of a bit washed now. I was worried that if this project didn't bang, it would be a serious problem for him. However, upon my first listen to this tape, I can honestly say, yo, I was pretty impressed with what I heard. So this 13 track project, which is about 44, 45 minutes long, so not even really too long, doesn't take up too much of your time. I really didn't want no 1 hour tape. I'm not gonna lie to you, 1 hour is a long time, you know, especially for when it's like 16, 17 songs. He chose a good number of 13, couple of skits in there, and the skits felt a lot more well-placed and, you know, very important for the theme of the album as we run through it. So for those who listen to ADHD, you know, they had the psychologist, and the psychologist taking a very dark turn. I ain't gonna lie to you, I was a weird psychologist there. That's, if your parents paying for that, you need to get your money back and keep it moving. Whereas in this album, Evolution, we see him talking to a teacher. In the first skit, you know, we see Joyner kind of talking about how he wants to change the world, his aspirations, his dreams, and the teacher be very supportive and encouraging this young Joyner to change the world and be a better man, and or be a better kid to grow up into a man, and really allow Joyner to kind of think about his feelings and, like, you know, share them, which sometimes some bad teachers ain't gonna let you do. As we go further into the album, we have the skit Tattle Tales. I think that's what, yeah, Tattle Tales. I was gonna say Telltales, and that's Telltale Games. That's a whole different type of thing. We have that skit, which is basically an enabler to the next song, Snitch, which had a video for it, which came out just before the album dropped, and basically looks at the two sides of snitching, which we're gonna talk about a little bit later. And then we have the skit Father's Day, which was a very interesting shift in the teacher, who, whereas before, allowed Joyner to be very free and, like, you know, allow him to express his thoughts and feelings. This time in Father's Day, the teacher is quite judgmental, looks at Joyner for being one of the only kids in the class, if not the only kid in the class, to not have a, like, a card for their father. But Joyner, who, well, young Joyner said, I don't have a father, this is why I'm giving it to my stepdad. And the teacher was like, says a lot about you. So, you know, you see a different shift as the album goes on about how the teacher's interactions, you know, go on with Joyner, which I thought was quite interesting and a good concept to have. Now, skits aside, I was really impressed with the flow of the album. I think when you go from the first skit into Evolution, which is the first track, and obviously the title track of the album as well, like, it was a really nice smooth transition where it just kind of drops. And obviously you hear Joyner talk about his more in depth as an adult now about his feelings and thoughts and aspirations as he's grown up, made money, and wants to be successful and continue to change the world in his vision, or in his mini universe in the wider world. Yeah, we see him talk about how he needs some retribution, how he's growing as a person and he's learned from his experiences as he grows up. Him talking about rubbing shoulders with people like Rihanna and then reassuring everyone that, yo, nothing's happening. It's just a situation where we could just have a conversation. And he's got to a place where he can engage with these big names, but not on a fanboy type thing, but actually be a friend to somebody who's like a Rihanna, who's very elusive, you know, but still share a relationship, which is just a friendship and a personal level. And also, just thinking about it, I would have been kind of awkward, because, you know, we were still waiting for that joint tape with Chris Brown. And if you'd come out and said that you're doing things with one of Chris Brown's exes, it would have been a bit sticky, and it would have made sense why the album had never come out. On This Way, featuring The Game Iyla, was a very interesting track as well. It definitely served as a mood shifter for the album, and by this point we're only three tracks in. The Game's verse was quite interesting because he spoke about the role of white women and, you know, having a mixed child and saying, what have you done to black men and black people as a whole? That was quite an interesting concept that he tackled. Joyner reflects on the fact that his stepdad changed his life for the better, and these come in between a very moody and very kind of like introspective hook from Iyla, who I enjoyed. I thought, yo, I need to check out Isla's work a bit more, you know, because I did like the fact that the song is quite long, but it didn't feel like, oh, here we go, like, can we finish, can we move to the next one? It didn't feel like that. Additionally, Joyner was also talking about people throwing stones at Black Lives Matter signs and staying in the house and kind of stay away from like cops because they're killing people, they're crooked, etc., etc. So again, reflecting of what's been going on in the time, but at least we can see that a lot of the stuff that he's talking about, whereas obviously we've heard about, you know, police brutality and cop stuff for beyond 2020, it's not like it's a random new thing. It shows that at least this album was recorded this year, or at least at the very least, the points that he's making hit more now than they would have maybe last year or the year before. Zim Zimma was decent. Obviously, he's using the Beanie Man Who Am I song, which is legendary across the world, and the actual beat itself was giving me like Drake non-stop vibes. There wasn't really much to talk about on that record, but you know, every single album's got to have like, not filler songs, but filler songs. You know, and a lot of the filler songs on this Joyner tape, they were still interesting, and songs that if they come up on shuffle, you're probably not gonna like switch off and be like, oh, this is long, and still served as quite enjoyable aspects of the tape. Now, the song Snitch is basically following the same kind of demon and angel or two-part motif that worked so well in the I'm Not Racist video. Now, obviously, that was one of the songs that really blew Joyner's, you know, career, because everyone thought at first that the white guy was Joyner Lucas, and then it turned out no, it wasn't. He weren't even in the video, or he was even in the video. I don't know why my voice went high pitch. I can't even remember, but I need to go back and rewatch that video. Talking about snitching, and you know, if you snitch, you know, then you might die and you might lose all your friends and family, only your mother might love you, whereas if you don't snitch, you know, you're gonna be able to still be good, you got money, you got this and stuff like that, and basically showing it from like a hood perspective of the consequences of snitching and the consequences of telling. And obviously it seems to be aimed very much at 6ix9ine, but could be about anything as well. It might have been recorded before, probably was recorded around the 6ix9ine thing, probably used to add more impact, and obviously we've got a video for it to build a real campaign around it. So yeah, that kind of makes sense. So for example, Take the Stand or Be Bobby Shmurda in the song was kind of like that main theme. Only thing I would say with this song in particular is he's done this concept before. I do like the song, don't get me wrong, but I don't know if Joyner wants to be known as that guy, because some people might listen to the snitch, but they're not listening to the album. So is Joyner going to be known as that guy who just does the two-sided different things, a bit like Guilty Conscience with Dr. Dre and Eminem back in the day, or I'm Not Racist and that? Is he going to go down and just be that guy, or how is he going to get people to kind of listen more to the songs that are not like that and not make him just seem as a storyteller instead of the musician as a whole? Also, linking it to Dr. Dre, because you hear snitch, I don't even know if you can pick that up on the microphone, but with that in the background, it reminded me a bit like Dr. Dre's The Watcher as well. So I saw a few elements and a bit of synergy between, you know, the two songs there. Now, I ain't gonna lie to you. See, Straight Like That, again, a song that didn't really necessarily offer anything too much to talk about, but it was giving me certain little Rod waivers, you know, that was them. I was about to say, heart been broke so many times, don't know what to believe. Nah, but in all honesty, like, it was a good song. There's not really much to talk about on that one, but it definitely gave me a little bit of Rod Wave vibes in there, and there was a few little instrumentations in the background that was making it sound special, you know, so that's definitely a song I'll have on repeat for a while. Obviously, we had the main one, which came out, which is Fall Slowly, an extended version exclusively for the album, which has Ashanti on it. And you know what? I like the song. I just don't know if it was powerful enough to be a single off the record. And don't get me wrong, that was one of the main struggles I have with this record. I'm like, Fall Slowly, okay, cool, snitch, cool, follows the stuff from the past, but in 6 months, a year's time, what song is gonna get people to go back and be like, yes, that's the song? Because I think it's a good body of work. I just don't know if it has that song. And I feel like as much as Fall Slowly and the extended version subsequently is good, I just don't know if it's the one. Do you know what I mean? Legend featuring Rick Ross, which was a good, another good song. And I think I would have liked, and maybe there is a video, I don't know, I need to check, but I would have liked to have seen a video for that song as the main song that came out. Joyner sitting there with Rick Ross on a very much Rick Ross-esque type beat. Rick Ross kind of does what he always does. Joyner talks about, again, evolution, being a legend, playing this song at his funeral so he can get resurrected, etc., etc. And you know, it works. It really works. And I like the fact that, you know, Rick Ross was on the record. I like the fact that Joyner and Rick Ross didn't sound out of place with each other. Very, very good song. Probably one of my favorite cuts off the album as well. Before I forget as well, Joyner's also talking about the grind at working at CVS, which my European self, or English self, believes is a pharmacy out in America. So Americans, if you're watching, if you know he worked at CVS and it is a pharmacy, let me know in the comment section down below. And the final song, Like a River, featuring Elijah James, was definitely interesting again as well. Like, we saw him talk about the relationship with his father. Joyner Lucas talks about the impact of having his shaky father around, saying that, you know, Joyner wants his son, you know, to know that he's got him there and he's supporting him, whereas Joyner's dad didn't. And maybe it's because Joyner's grandfather, aka Joyner's grandfather died early, so that's why it affected his dad. That's what he kind of had come up with as his hypothesis. God, that was a tongue twister. And also kind of the insufficiencies that Joyner's father, you know, bringing women around, some that Joyner liked, as he referenced in the song, and others he didn't. And it showed that, you know, like, that has given him some sort of a bit of like scarring and PTSD, and he wants to use that, and again, links him with evolution, to work harder and become a better person and really push and strive for success with his kid and, you know, the next future and the evolution, etc., etc. But yeah, that's it. That's the tape. Joyner Lucas, Evolution. Overall, really enjoyed the tape. More than I expected. Yeah, I think I'll be giving this one a little listen to a bit more over the weekend. But what did you guys think of the record? Let me know in the comment section down below. What's your favorite track? Which one are you feeling? Which one are you not feeling? Make sure you leave a like if you enjoyed the review as well, because every single like helps push this video out into the wide YouTube space and does me wonders. You know that one's there. So come on, do the tick. If you're new as well, subscribe. Subscribe is free. What's wrong with you? It's free. If you're already subscribed, then you're my boy, innit? Or you're my girl. I got you. You know what I mean? But if not, then you know what to do. Anyway, I'm out the building. I'm going to go. I'll catch you guys sometime soon. So in a bit, peace.